Minasan, konnichiwa, Zamura Injira desu. In this lesson, number 5 of chapter 11, we'll describe the use and content of the stockholders' equity statement. So we have the following example for Hampton Corporation stockholders' equity statement for the year ended December 31, 2019. We have balance January 1. So what are these column? Common stock, paid in capital and excess of par, common stock, retained earnings, treasury stock, and total. So look at the balance January 1. So actually, they have balance from previous accounting cycle, accounting period. These titles, common stock, are actually account names. For the last time, maybe for the last time, I will say this. These are account names. Common stock account name. Paid in capital in excess of par, common stock account names. Retained earnings, another account name. Treasury stock, another account name. Okay, so there are four account names here. So should 5,000 shares of common stock at $15, common stock 25,000. What about the in excess 50,000? Okay, because that is total 75,000. So however, for the common stock, $5 is the price per stock. So that's why 5 times 5,000, that is 25,000. Okay, take note, 5,000 shares. Okay. And declared a $40,000 cash dividend. $40,000. Why it is located at retained earnings? Look, it is presented using parentheses, meaning it is negative. So meaning it is subtracted. It is being sourced out of retained earnings. The 40,000 will be coming from the retained earnings. Okay? Then purchase 2,000 shares for treasury at $16. So another numbers inside the parentheses. So under the treasury stock. Okay. Look, treasury stock, they are both with parentheses. So they are both negative. Okay. So net income for the year. You can look at their retained earnings. You have to subtract now. Because we have to add or subtract depending upon. So we have the balance December 31. So one straight to accounting period. So take a look, and familiarize yourself. Okay. When a stockholder's equity statement is presented, a retained earnings statement is not necessary. So it is either or, no? If you already have a retained earnings statement, then well and good. But when equity statement is there, no need for retained earnings statement. Because it is already there. Retained earnings statement is only a part of stockholders' equity statement. But there are four financial statements, one of which is retained earnings statement. But retained earnings statement is part of a bigger statement, which is called stockholders' equity statement. Okay, so that's it. That reports what? Common stock, paid in capital, net excess of par, retained earnings, and this treasury stock. and other types of stock, there are others. Okay, so all about the stockholders' equity. So this is one very important concern. So retained earnings statement is already here. Take a look. Retained earnings beginning, that is balance January. Retained earnings ending, that is the balance December 31. And what? Net income for the year. That is, the only difference here is the declared 40,000. That is supposed to be recorded on the retained earnings T accounts, but reflected here for the purpose of showing it and presenting to the stockholders owner, to the owners or to the stockholder. So this is the end of this discussion of lesson number 5. Again, this is Dr. Ipi, preaching engineering for nation building.